Today, we're going to be upgrading our PS5 storage using the Western Digital Black SN850 1TB SSD with Heatsink. We'll also show you the process to install the SSD drive in the PS5, as well as test a game both on the internal and compare it running off the WD SN850. Keep in mind that storage expansion is still in beta, as of posting this video, and that there are many other SSD options out there still being tested. Sony has not yet given their recommended drives, but we'll link out to Reddit's list of tested drives in the description of this video. The WD SN850 can be found on many retail sites, including Amazon, GameStop, and others, but they might be out of stock, so we'll put links in the description to the best prices. Also, we decided to get a drive with a heatsink already installed, but you do have the option to buy and add a heatsink to other compatible SSDs, but more on that later. Installing the drive in the PS5 is unfortunately not quite as easy as the Xbox. There are a few extra simple steps. Step 1, remove the bottom cover of the system. Flip over the PS5 so that the PlayStation logo is table side down and on your top right. Now, grab the plastic plate, pull up gently and out towards you. The plastic plate should pop off easily. Next, you'll want to unscrew and remove the plate protecting your SSD expansion slot. If you got your hands on a drive already equipped with a heatsink, then you're good to go ahead and plug it right in and use the provided screw to secure the SSD in there. If you don't have a heatsink, you can pick one up on Amazon for pretty cheap, usually around $10, and they're very easy to install. NAS Compares has a great guide on the process that we highly recommend. Once everything's snug in the system, you can close everything back up and turn her on. As you can see, this drive does get recognized and we're getting a current read speed of 6,552 megabits per second, which is well above PlayStation's recommended speeds. Now let's transfer over a game and see how it runs. We transferred over Spider-Man Miles Morales, coming in at 39 gigabytes, and it went pretty quick. Testing the load speed before and after transferring it to the SSD, we're happy to report that we couldn't notice any slowdowns in gameplay or loading, and it even seemed like Spider-Man loaded faster on the WD drive than on the internal PS5 drive. And others have also reported seeing the same improvements. So far, we're pretty happy with the WD SN850 to extend the storage of our PS5. Looking at the price, we paid $249 for our 1TB SSD with a heatsink, but you can get the 500GB version for $139 or the 2TB version for $429. But for Western Digital and others, you'll definitely have an easier time getting your hands on an SSD without a heatsink and installing it yourself. And this is also the cheaper route to take. Let us know if you want us to do a guide on the cheapest option out there for the PS5. Alright, that's it for now. Let us know if you found this video helpful, and be sure to click the like button to support the channel.